Assalamu alaikum, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry for being delayed because of the absence of members. And before we formally start our today's proceedings, I would like to request Mr. Khalilullah Sheikh to please come to the podium for recitation from the Holy Quran. Mr. Khalilullah Sheikh, please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووزعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب صدق الله العظيم.
جزاك الله خليل الله شيخ. Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, my name is Riaz Ar-Rahman. I am CPD convener of the SRC of the Institute. I am a partner in Ernst & Young 4. Siddharth Heather. It is indeed my pleasure to welcome you all and our distinguished speakers, President ICAP, Vice President ICAP, and worthy council members. With that, I would like to invite Mr. Najm, Chairman SRC, to please come to the stage with the worthy speakers. Please welcome. The chief guest, Mr. Asrarov, will be joining us soon. As you know, consistent with its past practice, the SRC of the Institute has arranged a seminar to discuss and finalize budget proposals to be submitted to the Government of Pakistan, in particular the Federal Board of Revenue, so that in respect of direct and indirect taxes, so that due consideration to be given to our recommendations while formulation of the upcoming budget. This year's federal budget is expected to have special significance because the Government of Pakistan is reportedly considering to promulgate VAT laws in place of existing sales tax and central excise duty, effective July 1, 2010. Several new definitions and concepts have been introduced in the proposed VAT legislations, which are very important. And it appears that the scope of services that would be subjected to tax would be enhanced, and they have decided to withdraw various exemptions available in the existing law, like zero rating tax and things like that. Although there is a lot of concern and criticism from various quarters, including the business community, on the proposed imposition of VAT, it however seems that the Government of Pakistan is committed to impose VAT because in order to honor its commitment to the International Monetary Fund, which has reportedly delayed its tranches and further financial assistance till compliance of all the covenants of the standby loan arrangement. Ladies and gentlemen, on the one hand, amid steep inflation and unemployment, the common people of the country are hoping for the fresh air to come in the shape of few incentives for them and relief from the Government of Pakistan. While on the other hand, the businessmen and industrialists are also looking forward to appropriate fiscal incentives for them so that they are able to contribute to the national exchequer and the economy of the country with greater zeal and enthusiasm for the country. Similarly, there are a lot of expectations from various quarters for measures to be introduced in the upcoming budget to promote foreign investment in Pakistan. Having said that, it needs to be borne in mind that a war against terrorism is continuous in our country. Acute power shortage is a daily routine, which has affected the economy of our country badly. Therefore, I guess one would have to be very realistic in not expecting any miracles to come in the forthcoming budget. Our recommendations, hence, will have to be realistic and pragmatic under the circumstances and the current scenario. Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to present a welcome address here. I would not like to take any more of your precious time and would nonetheless inform you that we'll have two prayers break. One is for Asr prayer and second is for Maghrib prayers break. During the Asr prayers break, we'll also serve you tea, and the prayer timings would be around 6 p.m. to 6:20-6:25 p.m. Maghrib prayers break will be between 7 to 7:20 p.m. Now I would like to introduce our first speaker, Mr. Saqib Shirani. Mr. Saqib Shirani is currently Principal Economic Advisor, Ministry of Finance, Government of Pakistan. He has been a member of the Prime Minister's Economic Advisory Council since May 2008, and prior to his current assignment, he was heading the Economic Division of ABN AMRO Bank, which is now RBS. Over the last several years, Mr. Saqib has worked closely with the government on macroeconomic issues, and he has served Ministry of Finance, Board of Investment, and the Planning Division as a member of various task forces and working groups formed by the Government of Pakistan in respect of economic, fiscal, and investment policy of the country. He has done MBA and BBA from the Institute of Business Administration. Mr. Saqib is a regular speaker at various forums and presented many papers in the leading journals of economics of the country. Mr. Saqib will give his presentation on the economic outline of the budget. Ladies and gentlemen, let me now invite Mr. Saqib Shirani to come to the podium and give his presentation. Please give him a warm welcome.
Assalamu alaikum ji, and thank you for the introduction. Thank you for the invite to ICAP. I always look forward to coming here and again some valuable wisdom that is shared by your members and the speakers that you invite. In a break from tradition, aaj mere paas, you know, I normally have a media show, you know, a presentation, thoda sa asaan hota to take you through that. But this time around, unfortunately, I'm just, you know, going to bore you with a monologue. But I think content itna interesting hai hamari economic situation ka ke it may not be a bad idea to, you know, to keep you awake by telling you where we are, how fragile the situation is, and what we intend to, you know, what we should be doing about it, and what the contours of the next budget are likely to be. But before I go on, let me just, you know, talk about, mention the VAT that was, you know, just mentioned about, that the government of Pakistan is committed to this because it's been, you know, part of the IMF conditionalities of programs. I think as you will decipher, or as I'll say very explicitly, hopefully, during the course of my talk, you will discover that this is not an IMF conditionality. It may have been part of the program, but this program was homegrown. We took this program to the IMF and said, we want to introduce the VAT. Clearly, as I've been saying since last year at this forum and earlier as well, there is no other way except to raise the tax to GDP ratio and to broaden the tax base in Pakistan. VAT is one of the instruments to do that, but the government of Pakistan is fully committed to this program. It's certain things that can provide upsides, but there are also downside risks, right? And there are constraints, energy situation being one of the foremost right now. So let's not denude ourselves and think we can return to a high growth path immediately. So one of the key things is, what do we do? How do we navigate the economy to give it firm footing in terms of stability, macroeconomic stability, and then nudge it towards a higher growth trajectory as soon as possible, but one that is sustainable, one that is stable, and one that is equitable. We haven't had this combination or these three elements in the